I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey whippersnappers, Brian here to Boomer Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. I listen to rap and hip hop songs using lyric videos, and then I let you know what I thought about them. So today we're doing a poll winner. It's Onyx doing Slam. Now I have heard their names. Heard the name Onyx. It came up in a comment a while back. I forget what the reaction video was, but I mentioned their name, and then someone in the comments said, you know, they're hardcore. You probably wouldn't like it. So then when I was doing the reaction to Come Clean by Jeru the Damaja, their name come up again because Jeru was on tour with DJ Premier, and Premier, like to warm up his turntable, would play an Onyx song, and what was the name of that song? Throw Your Guns. So Premier would warm up his turntables with Throw Your Guns, and Jeru wanted to incorporate that the chorus of that song into Come Clean. So that's the other time I've heard of Onyx. And then I put them on a poll and they won. I'm going to do a little bio because I have no idea who Onyx is. And then we'll get into the reaction. When Fred Lee Scruggs Jr., a.k.a. Fredro Starr, I'm going to say Fredo, I know, Fredro Starr was 13 years old, he moved from Brooklyn to South Jamaica, Queens with his family, including his older brother David, who was also known as Hussein. But this one is WHO$ANE. Between 1984 and 1988, Fredro studied at John Adams High School. Other students at the school included Marlon Fletcher, a.k.a. Big DS, Tyrone Taylor, a.k.a. Suave, a.k.a. Sunny Siza, Mr. Cheeks, and Freaky Ta. I think people should be limited to one a.k.a. It's only fair. Suave began rapping in Brooklyn in 1982 as a member of his brother's group Cold Crash Scenes, who had performed with Killer Priest. Oh, that's big. Unless Killer Priest wasn't big. Ultimately, his passion turned towards DJing. Fredro first met Suave and Big DS at a battle in Ajax Park. The three of them decided to lay some tracks down together, and they knew of another schoolmate named B-Wiz, who had an SP-12 in his basement. They recorded some demos and decided to name themselves Onyx because it was a shiny black stone that can't be broken. In 1989, Onyx signed Jeffrey Harris as their manager, who helped them secure a contract with the label Profile Records. In April of 1990, the group released their first single, Ah, and We Do It Like This, which did not gain much attention. About this time, Fredro's cousin Kirk Jones from Brooklyn moved in with him. In Brooklyn, he had been a member of a street gang called Lowlifes that mainly engaged in shoplifting, hence his nickname, Sticky Fingers. In 1991, despite the admonishments of Fredro, a frustrated B-Wiz sold his SP-12 and moved to Baltimore to sell crack. He was killed that same year, and most of Onyx's recordings were lost. But like, he had the only copies? In July of 91, while in a traffic jam at the Jones Beach Greek Fest Festival, the three members of Onyx met Jam Master Jay, who after some discussion gave them 2 months to submit a demo to him. When the deadline came, Swab and Big DS were stranded in Connecticut and couldn't come to the studio to record the demo. But they waited until like the last day of their 2 months to record. Okay, so Swab and Big DS are MIA in Connecticut. Their manager, Jeffrey Harris, called Fredro and told him, I'm going to switch between Fredro and Fredro. That way I'll be right 50% of the time. Called Fredro and told him to come to the studio and bring his cousin Kirk, who at the time was attempting a solo career using the name Trop. Fredro and Eric recorded 2 songs, Stick and Move and Exercise. Jam Master Jay liked these songs, and that's how Eric joined the group as Sticky Fingers, Fingaz, because Jay said, if Sticky ain't in the group, it ain't no group. Jay signed the group to his label JMJ Records for a single deal, then for an EP deal, followed by an album deal, because they did 10 songs on a budget of 6 songs. Onyx hired Shiloh? I'm going to go with Shiloh. Onyx hired Shiloh Parker, aka Shy Skills, as their producer. Their first single, Throw Your Guns, that's the Jeru, the Damaja song. Their first single, Throw Your Guns, was released in November of 92 and was a huge success, charting on 4 Billboard charts and reaching number 1 on the Hot Rap Singles chart. They started to work on their debut album called Back to Fuck Up. But by the time the album was done, Jam Master Jay decided Onyx didn't have its hit single yet. He sent them back into the studio. I keep saying I'm going to make a list of all the songs that became hits that were, you know, these last minute requests from record labels after the album was done. It happens so often. Sticky Fingers remembers, quote, we needed to make a song that was just as aggressive or more aggressive, but can play on the radio. Def Jam was like, yo, Throw Your Guns is killing it. We need something else to come on top of it that's more radio friendly, but is still energetic. Slam was the very last song that we recorded for the album. We made that song to do what it did. We didn't choose it. No one came in and picked it. That song was intentional. It was deliberate. Unquote. Back to Fuck Up. I'm going to laugh every time I say that. Was released in March of 93, 5 months after the release of Throw Your Guns. Slam was released as a single in May of 93 and became their breakout single, making it to number 4 on the Billboard Hot 100. Fredro recalls, quote, we wanted to bring slam dancing to rap. Believe it or not, Nirvana was a huge influence on us. Red Hot Chili Peppers, too. When we was writing the album, Smells Like Teen Spirit would come on all the time on MTV, and they had slam dancing in that video. So that kind of triggered that. Run DMC did the rock thing before, but nobody brought slam dancing until us. We took it to another level, unquote. The song was produced by Jam Master Jay and Shy Skills. All right. I suppose it could be Chai Skills, but I'm going with Shy Skills. Okay. Onyx, Slam.
Everybody wanna sound good. before I bust on my pants. The mad author of anguish, my language polluted. Onyx is heavyweight.
It's still undisputed.
It took the words right out my mouth. I walk a mile in my shoes. I pay so many dues. I feel used and abused, and I'm so confused. Now, excuse me, for example, I'm an inspiration of a whole generation. And unless you got 10 sticky fingers, it's an imitation, a figment of your imagination. But wait, it gets worse. I'm not watered down, so I'm dying of thirst. Coming through with the scam, foolproof plan. B-boys make some noise and just yell.
Well, that's probably going on my next top 10 list. I really like that. It's going to be another, speeding ticket for me. I liked the aggression. I mean, it wasn't that bad. When they each did their verse, the first time was at Fredro, the first time. I forget who was first. I thought, well, wow, he's really good. And then whoever came in second, I thought, oh, well, he's even better. And then Sticky Fingers was last, and I thought, oh, well, he's the best of all. Such a unique voice. The beat startled me, kind of. Well, it didn't startle me. Surprised me, because I thought it was going to be real jazzy, because there's, trumpet or a clarinet or something at the very beginning, and then it turned into slam ba da ba. A great chorus. That's a great chorus to sing in your car with your friends. So I'm all over this song. I really like it. And I guess I should listen to some more Onyx. Put some good songs of theirs down in the comments. Well, thanks for voting for that, guys. This is right up my alley. Thanks for hanging with me. If you like this kind of content, give me a like and a subscribe, and I will see you on the next video. Bye.